Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about what an SSL LUCKY13 attack is. So let's get started. The SSL LUCKY13 is a cryptographic timing attack that can be used against implementations of the transport layer security and datagram transport layer security protocols using the cipher block chaining mode of operation. This can also be considered a type of man-in-the-middle attack. The ALS protocol, the successor of the secure sockets layer protocol, provides privacy, data integrity, and secure traffic between communicating networks or applications. The vulnerability that makes the SSL LUCKY13 possible affects the TLS 1.1 and 1.2 and DTLS 1.0 or 1.2 implementations. It also affects previous versions such as SSL 3.0 and TLS 1.0. The possibility of the LUCKY13 attack was established by security researchers Namal Fartin and Kenny Patterson. It is called LUCKY13 due to the 13 bytes of the header information in the TLS MAC calculation that is part of the vulnerability and makes the attack possible. The vulnerability that allows the SSL LUCKY13 to be made is due to a flaw in the SSL TLS specification, rather than due to issues in specific implementations. The attack can be considered a more advanced type of padding oracle attack that exploits different calculation times depending on the plaintext being padded with 1 or 2 bytes, or containing incorrect padding. Under OpenSSL, the attack allows a full plaintext recovery, whereas for new TLS, a partial plaintext recovery attack can be conducted. In the latter case, an attack can recover up to 4 bits of the last byte of blocks of plaintext. As a result of a successful attack, an attacker exploiting this vulnerability is able to read the plaintext of a TLS encrypted session. This can result in the loss of sensitive information. In a nutshell, this attack relies on a difference in processing times between TLS messages with at least 2 bytes of correct padding and TLS messages with 1 byte of correct padding or incorrectly formatted padding. Transport layer security messages with 2 bytes of padding are processed somewhat faster, and this difference can be detected when the arrival of TLS error messages is timed. Attacker-generated ciphertexts are sent to the same place in the plaintext stream during several TLS sessions to establish this difference. This generates an error message in the network as a response. By repeatedly launching an attack and carefully analyzing the responses, these different padding conditions can be distinguished from each other. Then, using the packet's timing data, an attacker can execute a plaintext recovery attack on the MAC check while processing a malformed CBC padding. In its most basic version, a LUCKY13 attack requires about 223 TLS sessions to collect a whole block of TLS encrypted plaintext. This can be reduced several times, and under the best circumstances, an attacker needs 213 TLS sessions to recover 1 plaintext byte. This is premised on the condition that the attacker is close to the target to reduce any noise and perform the timing attack. To generate the necessary TLS sessions, attackers have several options. As a result of the attacks, a TLS session that is running may be terminated. Applications that use this protocol may then attempt to reconnect and will also send cookies or authentication credentials. Another way of generating sessions is through the use of malware on the client side. This is akin to a beast attack, though it does not need to circumvent the same origin policy, because it is not a form of injection attack. In DTLS sessions, attacks can even be executed within a single session with the help of amplification techniques that make the timing signals more pronounced and easier to spot. Launching a TLS attack requires some conditions to be in place. Attackers need to be located on the same LAN that they are attacking and must generate enough sessions to discern the time signals of the sessions from the noise in the network. i.e., they require a very controlled environment and a lot of time for the successful execution of the attack. As such, the SSL LUCKY13 does not pose a grave threat to most TLS users. However, due to the widespread use of TLS, attacks against the protocol must be monitored and evaluated. More generally, this type of attack demonstrated flaws in the CBC cipher suites used by TLS and DTLS protocols in specific versions. However, since there are newer and better ciphers, mitigation against this type of attack can easily be achieved. Moreover, patches for TLS and DTLS libraries and CBC platforms that address this vulnerability have been developed and are widely available. This includes patches for OpenSSL, NSS, NewTLS, PolarSSL, USSL, MatrixSSL, Opera, Bouncy Castle, and JavaSE. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.